So let us first come to bottom-up parsing. So bottom-up parsing is also known as the shift-reduced parsing. Bottom-up parsing is used to construct the parse tree for an input string. So in bottom-up parsing, the parsing starts with the input symbol and construct the parse tree up to the start symbol by tracing out the rightmost derivation of the string in reverse. So in general, shift-reduced parsing is LR parsing. And here L stands for scanning the input from left to right and R stands for constructing a rightmost derivation in reverse. So here we have one example. Here we have one production where A's produces ABE, A produces ABC or B, and B produces D. So if we start from S, we can see that gradually we are coming to the output. From S we have A, first we have B, which is producing D, and A is producing ABC, and again A is producing B. So in the next derivation, we have found out S to be A, AB and E. We have substituted the value of B as D. And next we have A, so we are substituting one A as ABC. So it will come out as A, ABC, DE. And finally, we will substitute the value of A with B. And we will get the output result of which was ABBCDE. And so we have here our bottom-up parses. And we have different kind of LR parses, LR0. The SLR1, which is the simple LR, and LALR, which is the look ahead LR, and CLR, which is the canonical LR. In our presentation, we will look into the topics of SLR and CLR. So next, let us come to what is SLR parser and CLR parser. SLR is simple LR. It is the smallest class of grammar, having few number of states. SLR is very easy to construct and is simple to LR parsing. The only difference between SLR parser and LR0 parser is that in LR0 parsing table, there is a chance of shift reduce conflict because we are entering reduce corresponding to all terminal states. We can solve this problem by entering reduce corresponding to follow-up LHS of production in terminating state. This is called SLR1 collection of items. So now let us come to what is CLR parser. The CLR parser stands for canonical LR parser, as I have said before. It is a more powerful LR parser. It makes use of look ahead symbols. This method uses a large set of items called LR1 items. The main difference between LR0 and LR1 items is that in LR1 item, it's possible to carry more information in a state, which will rule out useless reduction. State and this extra information is incorporated into the state by look ahead symbols. And we have here one general syntax where A producing alpha dot B is a production and small a is a terminal or the right end marker is the symbol and LR1 items equals to LR0 items plus look ahead.
Here one example is given. In this example, we have to check the given grammar is LR0 or not. The given production rules are S to AAAB or S to BBBA, A to epsilon and B to epsilon. To find the grammar is LR0 or not, first we have to find the augmented grammar. Then we have to check, calculate the first and follow set for the given grammar. From this, we are drawing the transition diagram and from there, we are getting the parsing table. From this parsing table, we can conclude if this grammar is LR0 or not. Here, we are summing up all the three slides of previous. So, to find the augmented grammar of S, we first have to find the S dash value, which is dot S. From S, we get dot AAAB. From S, to get A dot BBBA. A two dot as there is no other production than epsilon and B two dot as there is no other production rules than epsilon. Now we have to calculate the first and follow set. To calculate the first set, we have to calculate from the bottom. So first of B, which is epsilon, first of A, which is epsilon, and first of S, as we have two production rules for S, so we have to find the first value for the each production rule. So first of AAAB union first of BBBA. Now as the first term is a non-terminal value for the both case, so we have to find what is the value for those. If it is epsilon, then we have to deduct the epsilon and find the first value for the rest of the production. So in both cases, first of A minus epsilon union first of AB union first of B minus epsilon union first of BBBB. As first of A and B both are epsilon, so we're deducting the epsilon, and for the rest of the value, as both are both are terminal, so we are putting that value. So from this we get that first of S is A and B. And to find the follow set, follow of S is dollar, as S is not used in any other production rule. Follow of A is used in first production rule twice. So first to calculate that, we get first of A, small capital A B union first of B, which is A and B, and for low of B similarly we are getting for A and B. Now we are drawing the transition diagram. First in S0 we are listing all the augmented grammar. For the first S0 augmented grammar, we are getting I1 transition state, which is S dot to S dot. For the first one, we are getting S I2 transition state, which is S to A dot AAB. For the second one, we are getting I3 transition state, which is S to B dot BBA. For A2 dot and B2 dot, as they are already completely reduced, so we are not getting any step from those. From I2, we are getting I4, and there are two stages in this, S to AA dot AB. As after dot, we are getting a non-terminal value, so we have to write the transition state for that, which is A2 dot. And similarly, from I3, we are getting two stages in I5 transition state, which is S to BB dot BA and B2 dot. From I4, we are getting transition state I6, S to AAA dot B, and from I6 we are getting I8 S to AAA B dot, which is after reduced step. And from I5 we are getting I7 B to BBB dot A, and from there we are getting I9, which is B to BBB A dot, which is also our final state or reduced state. Now we are drawing the passing table from the given diagram. For I0 input, we are getting three transitions, 1, 2 and 3. So we are putting 1, 2 and 3 in S, A and B in go to state. And for action, as the A2 dot and B2 dot are completely reduced, and from their first set, we are getting A and B as their first set. So we are writing R3 and R4, which is reduced 3 and reduced 4 in A and B places. I1 is a complete reduced step, so we are writing accept here. I2 is shifted to I4, so we are writing S4 here. I3 is shifted to I5, so we are writing S5 here. For I4, we are getting I6 for a non-terminal value, so we are writing 6 here. And in this I4 stage, we have one reduced state, so we are writing R3 for A and B value, which is the follow set of A. And from I5 we are getting the I7 state for the capital B, so we are writing 7 in this place. And we have one non-terminal complete set here, so we are writing I4 in A and B place, as they are the first value for B. Now from I6 we are getting I8 transition state for B, so we are writing S8 here. From I7 we are getting I9 for A, so we are writing S9 here. I8 is a completely reduced step, so we are writing I1, and I9 is completely reduced state, so we are writing R1 in this places. From this we can conclude that as there are multiple entities in I0 row, so we can say that this grammar is not a LR0 grammar. Next, there is one example for LR1 grammar which shall be discussed by Somasri.
Here we have an example: check capital A small a, or capital small b capital A small c, or capital B small c capital or capital small b capital B small a. And here we have another two productions: capital A derives d small d, capital B derives small d. So we have, when we have to prove LR1, the grammar is LR1 or not, so we have to find the first augmented grammar, then calculation of first set and follow set, then we have the transition diagram, then LR1 parsing table, and the sum of those three slides, here we have the total solutions. So for so in this example, LR1 means CLR1. Now find the first step. Step is make the grammar as augmented grammar. A grammar becomes augmented when we add an augmented rule that derives to the start symbol of the grammar. So by adding the augmented rule, the new grammar becomes is dash derives dot is that is derives dot capital A small a, is derives dot small b capital A small c, is derives dot capital B small c, is derives dot small b capital B small a. And here we have two non-terminal symbols, and there are the productions that a derives dot d and b derives dot d. These are the seven rules of augmented grammar, and the rule number zero is called as augmented rule. So in the next step, we have to calculate the first step. So first B is D, and the first A is D, and the first S is first A, capital A union first B A C union first B C union first B B A. So here the first we have a non-terminal symbol. So this derives small d. So here we put the small d union. First we have terminal symbol B. So we put that, and that's next we have non-terminal symbol B. So we put that the derives value is d, and then we have non-terminal value B. We put that, so we have that B comma D. Here is the follow set, and in the transition diagram we have the canonical collections of LR1 item. So first LR1 item set is obtained by finding the closure of S dash derives to dot S comma dollar. So this is the first step of DFS. So as we know, the first step is S dash derives to dot S comma dollar. So the given set of production rules are these. So the for applying closure, we need find the symbol which followed by dot. So after dot, here the symbol is S. So we need to add all the productions in the given grammar by placing dot to the first and up finding the look ahead symbol. So the rules becomes S derives dot A capital A small a comma look ahead is dollar, because in the similar way is derives dot b a c comma dollar, is derives dot b c comma dollar, and is derives dot b b c comma dollar. Here we have two non-terminal symbols. So a derives dot d comma a as look ahead, because here capital after capital A we have a small a symbol. So so it is the look ahead symbol of capital A. And similar in the similar way, capital B derives dot D comma C as look ahead symbol. So in the first let us call that as I zero. From this state, we need to make the transitions on the symbols that are followed by dot. So when the first symbol here after dot is S, so when we get S as input from this dot is placed after the S, and we transit the to new state by performing go to actions, and the rule becomes S dash derives S dot comma dollar as look ahead. In this state there is no symbol after the dot, so we have to stop here, and let us call this as I1, and this is the final state. And next we have dot a dot a to be get capital A as input, and here we put we get is derives a capital A dot a comma dollar as look ahead. Here capital and after dot we have one another symbol small a, so this is not the final step. So let us call it as I2, and then from this we get the as get a output as small a, and then we get is derives a as capital A small a dot comma is dollar as look ahead, and they comes consider is as state number I6, and this is the final state. From these we have another we get from these we get the b small b as input, and a zero, so here a zero is b dot ac, and a zero is b dot bba comma dollar is a look ahead value. Here we have two non-terminal symbols, so we put that also. So capital A and capital B also derives dot d, and capital A here after the capital A we have c, so the look ahead is c, and in b here we have a, so the look ahead is a. After that, we here we dot BC, so we get the B, capital B as input, and here we get is derives B dot C comma dollar as look ahead. Here's the after dot we have C, so this is not the and thus the last final state. Here we have I4, the call that they state I4, and here we get an input C, small c, and we get is derives BC dot comma dollar as look ahead, and thus let us consider it as I10, and this is a final set. We get we get the value D. Here we get the value, we get input D. So A derives D dot and B derives D dot, and A as a AC is a look ahead value of A and B. So this is the final state, and so it is called as I5 state. In the I3 state, we have another, in the first state we get A as input, and it becomes A derives B as BA dot C comma dollar. Let us consider is at I7 state, but it is not the final state. So we put C as input, and they let consider is derives BAC dot comma dollar look as carry look ahead, and this is the final set. To let us consider is at I11, and we get the B capital B as input, and is derives BB dot A comma dollar as look ahead, and let us consider it's at I87 state, and B here after dot we have A, and we get the A input as, and A derives BBA dot dollar as look ahead, and this is a final state. And I let us consider that I12 state. In that in the two we get an input D, and A derives D dot comma C, and B derives dot D dot comma A. This is the final this is the look ahead symbol of the A and B, and this is a final set, and I9. So in this transition diagram, we can see that no any other state does not contain multiple states. So we consider this grammar as LR1 grammar.
Can be taken by a bottom up partial for a grammar with no epsilon and unit production, so that the type A tends to epsilon and A tends to small a, to first a string with n tokens. So the n minus 1 is the tightness, and let us discuss why. So here the given question. So here the answer in B is n minus 1, so we get the n minus 1 move. So here we get our final step. So total 7 steps are required to for the reduction. So we here that we have also already discussed. Next, we have the question that when there is a reduced or when there is a reduced or reduced conflict, I or J for a terminal, then there is a reduced or reduced conflict, because it occurs when if a state doesn't know whether it will make a reduction operation using the production rule I or J for a terminal, E plus N and E multiplies N. So here it matches the D option. So the D option is correct.
Very good presentation by you all.